FLASHBLADE is the industry's first data hub, built to consolidate data-intensive workloads. In this video, we'll demo how streaming analytics and AI can be consolidated on a single storage platform. Here, we're showing a Twitter feed being analyzed with various tools like Hadoop, Spark, and AI applications, all on a single data platform, FLASHBLADE. Here, I'm using NiFi to manage all the pipelines. First, we started collecting data from Twitter. We're telling NiFi to collect any tweets that include keywords like dogs or puppies. And then we send the response to another process for simple JSON processing, and then the end results to Solr for real-time indexing. Now if I go to my dashboard on the top of Solr, we can see real-time histograms of tweet data, such as who are the most active Twitter users, what languages they used, and of course, the messages these top users tweeted. And here you can see traffic being generated in real time by the Twitter feed. We are also telling NiFi to send all the raw data to the FLASHBLADE S3 bucket. To do this, I'm telling NiFi that this is the endpoint to connect to FLASHBLADE. So with this ingestion, we can now go to Zeppelin Notebook to analyze the data. Here we're telling HDFS to look at this S3 bucket. And we're telling HDFS to do some simple read operations. And below it, you can see the raw JSON responses. You're also able to use Apache Spark to read the JSON data and run various queries. You can also convert JSON data to Spark data frames and print its schema here. But maybe we're more interested in analyzing who are the most influential users that like dogs and what they tweeted. You can easily do this with Spark data frames. Now you can do the same query using SQL. Here, using Spark SQL, you can see the results visualized in the bar graphs. So as you can see, with a couple of clicks and a couple of lines of code, we have done real-time data ingestion dashboarding and deep analytics on FLASHBLADE. Now, let's move over to our AI for dog lovers. If I go back to my NiFi flow and click into these groups, I'm basically telling NiFi to look at the tweet, if there's any pictures, then go and download it, and install the pictures on NFS mount. And just for demo purposes, I'm also sending the pictures to the S3 bucket. Now, let me start the subflow. Now that it's collecting dog pictures, let's move over to the S3 browser. And as you can see, we have the images of dogs from tweets being collected and stored on FLASHBLADE. Now we can start applying the AI model to detect dogs. Here we're using Jupyter Notebook, and we're using YOLO algorithm to help build an AI model that detects objects. And we'll use a pre-trained model, which we're loading in here. As you can see, this model has over 60 million parameters. That's a lot, and that's why you need GPUs to train these models. Now we're ready to deploy the model into production and expose it as a REST API for our application to consume. So I have my script to start the API server. I've also downloaded several images for the test. Let's start with the simple picture here. I'm using the script to send this picture to the REST API server to the left. It'll take a few seconds to recognize the dogs in the pictures. The results are stored in another directory over here. I forgot to put this picture up. This is the original photo. And this actually did a really good job of detecting the dogs. And it not only tells me that it's a dog, but also where the dog is. Let me try another picture, and I'll send this to the API. As you can see, the picture really isn't that high resolution, but let's see how the AI handles it. Not bad. It tells me there's a dog here, and a person here, and another person here. Unfortunately, it doesn't tell me that there's a small dog right here. Well, that concludes the demo. To summarize what we covered in this video, we showed how a single data hub, FLASHBLADE, can consolidate all analytics applications from Hadoop to Spark to AI. Head over to purestorage.com/datahub for more information. Thanks for watching.